Now, the political memoir is a chance for the writer to cast themselves as the hero in their own blockbuster. Their sins forgiven, their enemies smited, with some charming childhood photos thrown in to make you go, aww.
In Pull No Punches, Judith Collins MP tells the story of a humble Waikato farm girl who became a fearless high-flying minister whose dreams of leadership remain unrequited.
She's long been talked about as the national leader in waiting, a tough political bird who, like the title of her book suggests, isn't afraid to get blood on her hands. She's known as Crusher, thanks to her law calling for the squashing of cars belonging to recidivist boy racers. Cars very much like this.
Here's my car. It'll be interesting to see if she hops in. Hopefully she does hop in.
Now
I'll give you a hand in because it's a punishing seat.
Dear Lord, what are you guys doing to me? How the hell am I going to do that?
Oh, you're all right. No, you're good as gold.
Okay.
So when does the book come out?
It's in the bookstores on Wednesday beginning.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
Oh, hold on. Oh, no, sorry, this is my grandfather. I'm just going to take this, just very quickly.
No problem.
Hi, Grandpa, how are you?
Hi, Jeremy, are you there? Now listen...
Grandpa, I'm just about to interview Judith Collins, so if you don't mind...
Judith Collins? Oh, you mean Crusher Collins? Now, Judith, you need to hurry up and get rid of this Tim Miller guy. He's no good. You can't have a bald Prime Minister.
Oh, no, he's fine, dear, he's fine. I just like people being nice to deal with.
OK, then, I'll leave you to it. Right.
Okay.
All right, see you, Grandpa. Bye-bye. Goodness.
He could get me into trouble, couldn't he?
Yeah. All right.
Right, let's go.
Just reading between the lines, I feel like you're a big fan of the current Prime Minister, Jacinda Ardern. That's reading between the lines.
Well, I think she's the right person for Labour to have chosen at that time for them. I think there's some things she's done really well, and there are other things.
Let's just say that Judith hasn't been completely charmed by Jacinda, but Crusher was starting to charm me. And speaking of charm...
I was really interested to learn that you went to charm school.
Yeah, no. Sorry, I'm still working on that. But basically, you learn how to walk on a catwalk, and you learn how to do your nails, and learn how to dress properly and set a table. What are we doing here?
I'm just grabbing some... Great. Just grabbing some KFC. Hi there, do you want anything?
I don't eat KFC.
Okay.
That lid's not really on, Jeremy. A bit worried about that. That lid.
Oh, the lid's not on.
Not quite on. There we go, that's better.
I detected there was a little bit of tension between you and the former Prime Minister, John Key. I just detected a wee bit of... Did you feel he chucked you under the bus?
Oh, I think I sort of wrote that there, didn't I? I said, yeah, I felt truly, well and truly chucked under the bus.
So when do you want to be Prime Minister? I know that you want to be Prime Minister at some stage,
well,
otherwise you wouldn't put your hand up to be the leader of the National Party.
I was sort of joking, really.
What, you were joking?
I was joking because I knew that things were being done. I knew I didn't have the votes. The first time I put it up, it's because I didn't like Bill English just being anointed. It's not jolly royalty, what are we doing? You should actually have a competition, make it worthwhile. And the second time, I didn't have the numbers then, but I thought, well, I'm the only one who's had any experience in opposition, and so I'll show you what to do.
See, when I look at that photo there, I see, I mean, you're very cute, but I see ambition.
You can see it, can't you?
I can see ambition. I see the future Prime Minister.
Oh, do you? I see a very happy MP for Papakura.